This is the big, big bad man, the big double R, big papa. There were none before me, and there will be none after me. Therefore, that makes me the one and only. I'm old, I'm single, and I'm ready to mingle. Certified and bona fide, indubitably qualified to bring you satisfaction and a whole lot of action. Look out, baby, it's Rambo Red Track. I'm the baddest man on YouTube.
What's up, y'all? Back with your boy, Rambo Red Track. I'm going to give it to you like you like it, like you need it, and like you got to have it. Every time, right on time. Like and subscribe. Yeah. Shit right here. Hey, I came up with a great idea. I'm always looking for new ways to kind of expand my page. And so I was thinking about putting up, like all of Corey Holcomb's funniest moments each week from his show. Just like the funniest part, I think. And then I said, you know what? I'm going to take it even further. Some weeks it's going to be the funniest part, but some weeks it's just going to be the realest part. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, it could go either way with his show. It could go either way. So, today, we gonna keep it real on the 5150 show. Straight up.
Like, you know, she said something about Jewish people, and I'm right. Like, I didn't even say nothing crazy. The joke was like, I was saying how people always come and apologize after saying stuff about Jewish people.
Yeah.
And I'm like, nobody ever has the opportunity to stand on that shit. I've never seen nobody be able, like, Jewish people this and like, yo, I meant that shit. Every single time they have to double down and apologize.
Yes.
And I was like, what do Jewish people be doing, you know, to make people come back and apologize?
Right.
And I was like, you know, you leave and go home and the keys to your house don't work.
Right.
I'm like, well, you got erectile dysfunction.
Right.
I'm like, these niggas be fucking you up.
Right.
I'm Jewish and I just
grew up. Back to the motherfucker.
I said this and it got a laugh, but whoever was Jewish and Irish, they were on, I mean, literally emailing from the show. Like,
you know, I want to tell you something, sister. This is just advice. I'm a little older than you probably. How old are you, sister? Oh, you probably don't tell you, but it don't matter. I just want to tell you, I want to tell you that, do you know when you have to worry about what you say, it stifles your creativity? When you have to worry about shit like that, and I think that it's about time somebody say something and they stand on it, because I'm standing on what I'm going to say right now. It's unfair that the people, the Jewish community, who has the power over everybody, can come to you and have you apologizing for a joke when everything that has happened in this world by people getting blackballed, people getting in trouble and everything, they get mad at you over a joke and they make people apologize. I'm gonna tell you something. The joke that you just said right now, I don't see nothing you have to apologize for. I don't see nothing you have to apologize for. And that I think his name is Seller.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck the Seller, motherfucker. If I can't say what the fuck I want to say, fuck your club, Seller. I don't give a fuck about... Do you know how many comedians I know? Big-time comedians. Corey, you a rock the Seller. Woo, woo, woo. I'm like, well, I'll go up at the Seller, but I'm not finna kiss nobody ass to go up in this little funky ass club. So now, let's see, can Corey get canceled? Let's see, can I get canceled? But speaking the truth, we are tired of kissing ass. Not being able to say a joke. Listen,
that's great.
Kyrie didn't even say a joke. He simply reposted something
that he
and
liked.
They told him he need counseling. Come counsel me. Bring your little fucking rabbi motherfucker or whoever the fuck you want to bring. Holla at my weird ass. Come see what's up with Corey. Fuck it. I don't mean no harm. I'm just saying, you're not going to make me think I'm crazy because I cracked a joke. When everybody in this world and took a joke. Get the fuck out of here, man. We cannot be afraid to speak from the heart sometime.
Mm.
Especially if you don't mean no harm by it and you know that you're just being bullied. You're being bullied. I better not say that. Yeah, you better not say that because motherfuckers do things to try to destroy you and take your voice. Hey, man, look, let me tell you something about all that shit right there, man. It ain't working. Motherfuck the Seller.
Wait a second.
Get Corey canceled. Ah,
I want to know.
So that is why we all love that nigga, because I don't hear that. Well, there's somebody else out there that I know that does kind of bring it like that, and I'm not gonna say his name, But very rarely do you hear a real nigga that's already fucking made it say what the fuck needs to be said. Now, as you all know, I'm one of those real niggas. And that's why you love Ramo Rec Track. Guys, we're going to do this every week. I'm going to have the best moments, the funniest moment, or the craziest moment from Corey Holcomb for you guys. Ready for you to go, hot off the press. Hey, I'm Ramo Rec Track, the baddest man on YouTube.